الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونسترشده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ومعلمنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وأرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه واجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه وأدخلنا برحمتك في عبادك الصالحين أما بعد يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز في سورة يونس في الآية 62 ألا أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون Unquestionably, for the allies of Allah, there will be no fear concerning them, nor will they grieve. من هم أولياء الله؟ بالآية التي بعدها يشرح لنا الله سبحانه وتعالى من هم أولياء الله. فيكمل فيقول في كتابه العزيز الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون. هؤلاء هم أولياء الله. Those who believe and are fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, there's something very important that we need to remember about awliya Allah. Awliya Allah, ha'ula akhassahum Allah bi karamat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given these awliya special gifts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given these awliya special gifts. And he explained to us in a very important hadith, which is from Abu Huraira. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. هذا الحديث يعني يحذرنا من معاداة الأولياء أولياء الله. وبالتحديد أريد منكم أن تنتبهوا إلى موضوع الصحابة، لأن أغلب الصحابة صحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم هم أولياء الله سبحانه وتعالى، وبعضهم من العلماء يعني التابعين وتابع التابعين وغير ذلك. وموضوع المعاداة هو أن يكون مبغضا له أو يؤذيه، يعني أن يكون مبغضا لهذا الصحابي أو هذا العالم أو هذا الولي، أو يؤذيه، أو أن يقع في عرضه، أو أن يشمت به، أو أن يحاربه بأي لون من المحاربة. فهذا نوع من أنواع المعادات، من عادى لي وليا. ثم بالنسبة للموضوع فقد آذنته بالحرب، أي أعلمته بالحرب، فقل آذنتكم على سواء، أي أعلمتكم على سواء. فالإذان هنا بمعنى الإعلام، وقد تدل على التحقيق، وهذا يدل على أن محبة أولياء الله جل وعلا وهم أهل الإيمان والتقوى مطلوبة، فإن الذين يعادونهم يجنون على أنفسهم. ف this important issue about loving the أولياء of Allah سبحانه وتعالى is going to affect your life tremendously. If you love the أولياء of Allah, your life is going to be much better because you will learn from them. We learn from the knowledge. And some of the knowledge that they have, Allah gives them as a gift, which we will talk about in the story of Musa ibn al-Khidr in Surah Kahf, inshaAllah, in the next part of the khutbah. I'll give the example. And if you fight them, and if you take them as an enemy, it's going to affect your way your life so badly. Whatever money you make, your time, your health, your knowledge will be wasted on you to destroy you and to destroy your children and to destroy your future in this dunya and the hereafter. So this issue of trying to imitate awliya Allah and try to live like them and try to help them and try to assist them and try to support them and try to give them whatever help they need. And if they do mistakes sometimes, yes, you can correct them, but correct them in a very polite way, in a very proper way, without hurting their feeling, without hurting their families, and so many things about them. So these people, awliya Allah, we have to train our children to become close to them and to feel that it's a Eid day when we visit wali from awliya Allah, when we talk to wali from awliya Allah. And this awliya Allah, he could be the grocery shop man, he could be the butcher, he could be the taxi man, the driver, he could be any part in our community, because he has strong belief and high belief in Allah and he has taqwa. He lives according to the Quran. He lives according to the Quran and Sunnah. And he prepares himself for the Day of Judgment. And he's always thinking about death and preparing himself for the death. And he always lives with little bit of food or little bit of gifts, or just a normal car, or just a normal house, or a normal flat. This is taqwa. When he has money, he gives it to his poor neighbors, to his poor children, to his poor cousins, to his poor parents. He doesn't worry about saving so much for tomorrow and next year and next decade, because he knows that Allah has chosen him as a wali, and Allah is going to look after him. And Allah is going to give him a special support. So please make sure that this becomes part of our habit, inshallah, especially this coming holiday, that our children, they will be in 2 weeks or 3 weeks holiday, some of them in university. So read to them some of the stories of awliya Allah, like from the Sahaba, Umar ibn Khattab, Ali ibn Abi Talib, Affan ibn Affan, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, and our scholars and others and others. And even like our local butcher, or our local mechanic, or our local neighbor, or our local carpenter, who is God-fearing, he doesn't cheat, he cares about amana, he does not cheat, he cares about earning halal money, he does his job properly. This is wali from awliya Allah, depending on his profession and depending on his ability. أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين. الحمد لله. الحمد لله الذي علمنا في سورة الكهف قصصا رائعة ومهمة ومفيدة. والآن سنتطرق إلى القصة الثالثة التي تكلمنا في الماضي عن سورة الكهف وأهميتها لدراستها في يوم الجمعة لنحصل على النور من أسبوع إلى أسبوع. ونزيد عليهم 3 أيام. يعني الله قد يعطي زيادة لبعضنا 10 أيام نور يرون به الحق حقا والباطل باطلا. ويعني تتيسر أمورهم كثيرا. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الكهف الآية 65: فوجدا عبدا من عبادنا آتيناه رحمة من عندنا وعلمناه من لدنا علما. الله سبحانه وتعالى is telling us that Musa عليه السلام and يوشع بن نون, when they went to meet الخضر, they met this person with this description: وجدا عبدا من عبادنا آتيناه رحمة. See, we didn't give him money. Allah did not say we didn't give him money. Allah said we gave him rahma, mercy. Mercy. This is one of the karamat, special gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَوَهَبْنَاهُ نَعْمَ عَظِيمًا وَالْكَرَامَاتِ هَذَا مَا شَرَحَ الْمُفَسِّرُونَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran that when they went to that location, which some scholars, it's between Spain and Morocco, Jabal Tariq, that's the location. And there is another location which is mentioned in history as well. So there where they met Al-Khidr. And this servant, who was God's servant, he had mercy from Allah. Allah gave him special mercy. And it's given him special karamat. He can understand things. Now some scholars say that he's a prophet, and others say that he's not a prophet. But the issue is that a great messenger, Allah's messenger, went to visit him to learn from him important skills about the karamat, about awliya Allah. So this is a practical example that I would like you, you know, to be careful and to be aware that how important it is to ask Allah to give you the karamat and make you wali from awliya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As much as you can handle, because this is a big responsibility. By the way, قال له موسى هل أتبعك على أن تعلمني مما علمت رشدا. موسى told him, can I follow you? Can I join you? Can I be a good student with you so I learn some of the wisdom that you have been taught? A great messenger, a great Allah's messenger with azaim, with strength and ability, and lots of knowledge. Still, he told Al-Khidr, can I join you in your trip to learn some of the wisdoms that Allah has given you? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا. You are not going to be patient with me, with the actions I'm going to take, with the subjects I'm going to handle, with the tests we're going to go through. So knowledge and seeking knowledge needs huge amount of patience, dedication. When you join a scholar or a teacher, you have to be patient with him. Patience is crucial. So that's very important to teach our children, to be patient with the teachers who are teaching them the Quran, Hadith, Fiqh, and their schools. Teach your son and your daughter every day. How is your patience with your teacher? How is your patience with your brother at home, or your sister who's teaching you math, physics, or other subjects? Some of the children, they don't even have 10 minutes of patience to obey their brother or their sister while they're teaching them. This is how we are in bad shape, some of us, in our community. And I'm speaking this from history. I used to visit thousands and thousands of Muslim homes, and I know that their children don't have patience to sit down and learn from their brothers and their sisters. So sabr is important that we teach to our children. وَكَيْفَ تَصْبِرُ عَلَى مَا لَمْ تُحِطْ بِهِ خُبْرًا. How are you going to be patient with the things that you don't know about, you don't know much about, or you don't have the skills to be able to handle that patience and experience? قَالَ سَتَجِدُنِي إِن شَاءَ اللَّهُ صَابِرًا وَلَا أَعْصِي لَكَ أَمْرًا. A great prophet, great messenger, telling his teacher, you will find me very obedient. You will find me very patient. So he's trying to, in a good manner, telling his teacher, give me the chance. You will find me an obedient student. So sometimes you can be a professional person or a scholar in a field, but you have to consult with another person who is more expert in other fields than you. Be patient. Be kind. And prepare to learn the things he's going to tell you. And don't say, oh, I know better than him. Oh, I can find out things better than him. Oh, I'll be able to handle this kind of knowledge better than him. قال ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا ولا أعصي لك أمرا. I'll be obedient and I will not disobey you. قال فإن اتبعتني فلا تسألني عن شيء حتى أحدث لك منه ذكرا. So the teacher told the student, if you're going to follow me, do not ask me about things until I will tell you myself, until I'll mention it to you. until I mention to you. So when you're reading a book, or somebody is reading a story, or a book, or an article, and explaining it to you, or to your children, tell them to be patient, do not disturb, do not distract the teacher, until he finishes explaining every part of it. And he tells you what is good and what is beneficial to you. Because sometimes people say, oh, I'm going to take that piece of information and run away with it and spread it the way I want it, that's the way I understand it. No. You don't spread knowledge the way you understand it. You have to spread knowledge the way it should be and is supposed to be spread. Not according to your desire or to your specific understanding alone. You have to do it according to your teacher's understanding and to your teacher's experience and how he learned it and how he benefited from it and he spread it and he taught it to others and others and others. Inshallah, in the future, we'll talk more about it in details, Surah Al-Kahf. Now we're running out of time and many of you have to go to work. So, إني داع فأمن ورائي جزاكم الله خيرا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعائي. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واعف عنا واغفر لنا واعف عنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم ارحم شهداءنا وشهداء المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم وحد صفوفنا وصفوف المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم ارحم شهداءنا وشهداء المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم أعنا على طاعتك، اللهم أعنا على محبة أوليائك، اللهم أعنا على محبة أوليائك يا رب العالمين، واحترامهم والتعلم منهم يا رب العالمين، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم نسألك ألا نعادي ولا نبغض أوليائك يا رب العالمين. اللهم عقلنا وفهمنا وارزقنا الحكمة والرشد يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا الحكمة والرشد يا رب العالمين. وقل ربي زدني علما، وقل ربي زدني علما، وقل ربي زدني علما، والحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. May Allah reward you for listening to this khutbah. نسأل الله أن يجعلنا من الذين يسمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. Please make sure that when you go home today, you read Surah Al-Kahf and pray and ask Allah to forgive the Muslims who died today, this morning in New Zealand. May Allah forgive them and forgive everyone of us and protect them. And be vigilant, وَجَزَاكُمُوا خَيْرًا, and be very wise in your discussions. And be very careful what you say as well. وَجَزَاكُمُوا خَيْرًا. And please make sure that if somebody tried to put you in a situation or difficult situation to get something out of you, you know, about Australia or New Zealand, say, I don't know. Alright? Please do not involve in any bit, in any debate or any discussion that could harm you or harm your family. Please be wise about it. وَجَزَاكُمُوا خَيْرًا. وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.